Moving on now to the story that we're focusing on, and we're focusing on child locks. Now, back in 2017, we raised the issue here on Mirror Now, where we appealed to various governments, including the central government, to A, put out an advisory that helps women understand that there is a physical lock in the door of the car that when used and activated could lock you in that car and you won't be able to open the car from the inside. Now, this is a child lock. A lot of times, and in a lot of cases, we get into Ubers and Olas and other cars and not check that child lock. In several cases, assaults that have taken place or sexual offences against the women who were riding in those cars were actually done by first locking this door using that child lock. When we set out in 2017, we wanted to do two things. One is educate as many women as possible about this threat, because we all take these cars, and if you're watching at home and you're a man, I'm sure you have several loved ones who also take these taxis on a regular basis, and they do it alone. The government of India, on the Surface Transport Ministry under Nitin Gadkari, have decided that in 2019 onwards, all cars that are manufactured in India will come with a dismantleable car lock. And when they are registered as taxis, that car lock, that child lock will have to be removed. In Karnataka, an order was passed by the government that all taxis remove that child lock by the 20th of this month. We understand now that most of those taxis have refused. Take a look.
Three years ago on Mirror Now, we began a campaign to make taxis safer for commuters. Our demand? Ban child locks in commercial vehicles. This because errant drivers over and over again use these child locks to trap women commuters and then in some cases assault them.
This is the physical child lock facility. It's unlocked now. If it's pushed that way, it's locked. It's marked very clearly on all cars. Before you get into the car, check for this facility. If it is locked, this is what happens. You get in. Child locked car, you can only open the door from the outside, which means that the passenger in the back of the car is effectively trapped. The other thing we are going to do as a channel at Mirror Now is ask for all state governments, and every state has to do it, is to put a sticker on the car instructing every passenger to check the child lock and make sure the child lock is not on. The more important thing for the governments to do is to make sure that if a car is registered as a commercial vehicle or a taxi, the child lock is effectively taken away completely.
Karnataka became the first state to officially ban child locks in taxis.
Removal of child lock has been a relentless campaign across India. And after Delhi, we saw how Karnataka government implemented this particular rule.
But as Karnataka attempts to implement this ban, cab drivers are refusing to abide by the new law. Their reasons will shock you. Not only do the cab drivers claim that it's too expensive to remove these locks, they also say drivers shouldn't be blamed for the sexual assaults on women who wear revealing dresses and party late.
Woman safety avu 12 gantel tirgaadu ant yaru heltare avu maadode ardha alka kelsa maadkolodu pubbugalige hogodu avu kudkondu engannang hogodu yavano obba maadda andre ella driver hange maartara
ivattu hengagide andre driver kashta yaru kelavarilla ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬರು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಅವ್ರ ಸಾಲ ಮನ್ನಾ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಇವ್ರ ಸಾಲ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬ ಡ್ರೈವರ್ಗಳು ಕೇಳಿ ಕರೆಕ್ಟಾಗಿ ಒಬ್ಬರು ಬಟ್ಟೆಗಳು ಹಾಕೊಂಡಿಲ್ಲ ಕರೆಕ್ಟಾಗಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬಟ್ಟೆಗಳು ಹಂಗೆ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ.
As Mirror Now continues the campaign to ban child locks across the country, we ask, shouldn't moderators like Ola and Uber be made accountable to ensure their cars don't have child locks? After Karnataka, when will child locks be banned across India? Let's debate.
While child lock remains a main campaign here on Mirror Now to make sure that everyone is safe in taxis, there's a far bigger question that we have to address at this point of taxi drivers who believe that women who go to parties should not expect to be safe in a car, of women who dress a certain way should not expect that the drivers will not assault them, women who drink should not expect that the drivers will not assault them. So what they effectively said on camera, and these are people who represent the union of taxi drivers in Bangalore, the union of drivers of Ola and Ubers, they turned around and said, if you drink, if you go to parties, if you stay out at midnight, the driver will assault you, do not blame us. What sort of safety does that leave us really now? As far as public transport is concerned, so effectively what you're saying is that women should just stay home. It's completely atrocious. At what point will the women in this country actually be safe? Joining me on the show right now, Anand Gurumurthy for the BJP, Aishwarya Mahadev for the Congress. Sergius Barreto is the Content Development Editor at Autocar India. Vikram Singh, former DGP Uttar Pradesh. Tanveer Pasha is the President of the Ola Uber Drivers and Owners Association. Trisha Shetty is a lawyer and the founder of an NGO called She Says. I want to start with Tanveer Pasha, who joins us out of the Bangalore studio. Tanveer Pasha, if you can hear me, my question to you is this. Is it true that the drivers, and there are two union representatives who spoke to our camera person, who spoke to our reporter, who said, if women wear revealing clothes and party till 12 o'clock in the night, obviously they're going to be assaulted and molested. Is that the belief across your association, Mr. Pasha?
No, I don't believe in that, because it is all left to their mind, that dressing sense and all. We cannot judge about the dressing sense. We always respect the women as we are living in India. So, but I would say one thing about this child lock. Mm. The name indicates that is child lock for the child safety.
Yes.
So compromising with the child and giving safety measures to the women, is this right? So no, is
I'm,
there
I'm glad
any
you asked that question.
Other step taken for the children's safety?
Okay, I'm glad you asked that question.
So
then drive, Pasha,
see, many
if you allow me to answer,
happen
I'll answer.
In the midnight.
Yes, one second. The child lock is a specific innovation that was brought about in the West, where children are not allowed in the front seat, they have to sit in the back seat. Now, when the child is in the back seat, in a lot of cases alone, because the parent is driving and the child is required to sit in the back seat by themselves. So a child sitting alone in the back seat might fiddle with the car. Now, please tell me, in the Ola Uber Drivers and Owners Association, how often do you have a small child sitting in the back of your taxi alone?
Alone.
There are many cases. The parents also sit in the back seats wherever we pick the customers. Mm. And they don't think what their children is doing. They will be busy with the cell phones, or they're speaking to somebody else, or they're observing the navigation, something else. At the time, if children open the door, somebody will crossing the road, or somebody is traveling next to the cab.
So Mr. Tanveer Pasha, when these parents get into the car, do you inform them that you have locked, you have activated the child lock in all the doors and the doors will not open from the inside? Do they know that?
Yeah. Obviously.
So you are telling me, hang on.
Inform them, and many cases, parent only suggest us.
You're telling parent, me that every time a parent gets into the back of an Ola or an Uber in Bangalore, the driver briefs that parent on the child lock and asks whether the child lock should be activated. Is that what happens? Because my phone will start ringing immediately as soon as you confirm.
No, though many of them, they won't inform to their parents. Mm. But some parents only inform us to do the child lock.
How many parents have informed you? How many parents have requested that you activate the child lock when they sit in the car?
More than 40%.
More than 40%. All right. So if you happen, if you're watching right now at home and you want
to... Yes, rest of the responsibility.
One second. If you're watching at home, our phone lines are open. Get in touch with us if you believe that you are a parent in Bangalore who requested that the taxi activate the child lock whereby your car is not, you're not able to open it from the back seat. Now, past incidents where women used cabs and were in cabs alone in Bangalore and were sexually assaulted. 23rd August, Ola, Bangalore, woman booked a cab in Yelahanka, New Town. She was assaulted. June 1st, Ola, Bangalore. May 23rd, Ola, Mumbai. 20th April, Ola, Noida. 5th December, Ola, Delhi. 28th April, Ola, Bangalore. 27th April, Ola, Mumbai. It goes on. Now tell me, in how many of these cases, Tanveer Pasha, do you know where the child lock was used to assault these women? Do you know?
See, in the Bangalore, there are no cases such I have found that the child lock is on and they have harassed and molested with the women. I have not seen a single case because I am okay. I am observing all the cases in Karnataka.
June 1st, 2008, last year, 26-year-old woman architect booked a cab from Kodihalli to reach the airport. This was at 2:30 in the morning. The Ola driver, Arun, locked the doors and started sexually harassing her. He also threatened to call his friends and have her gang raped if she complained against him. You're not aware of this case?
No, that was not a child lock. Actually, when we install the remote control system in the cab, if we switch off the ignition, that time the door locks will be open automatically. Otherwise, manually we have to open the door locks. Because once the ignition is on, all the doors will lock in the automatic remote control system.
That is not a child lock. That is not true.
That was when
even
she
if
panicked,
the car is so ignition is on, you should door, be able to override the central locking system and be able to open it from the back seat. If you're not able to do so, it means the child lock has been activated. But I have someone who can answer this question for us. Sergis Barreto is the content development editor at Autocar India. Sergis, good evening and thank you for joining us. If you could help us understand this, this whole claim that the child lock is not the real problem here and taxi should not be asked to take it out. Is it possible that just because the ignition is on, the passenger was not able to open the car?
Certainly if you pull down the door handle, or in some models you have like a door tab, you lift that up, you can always open the door. The only time you will not be able to open the door is when obviously the child locks are on. It's not possible that the child locks were disengaged and the doors were still not opening. Certainly not in all the Olas and Ubers that at least I've seen. I don't think there is any system that will prevent you from opening a door.
Well, I want to take this question also to the two representatives of the government. Aishwarya Mahadev represents the Congress party. Aishwarya Mahadev, the cab owners association and the drivers association have refused to take out the child lock because they say it's too expensive and they want help from the government, and they seem to think that it is not the problem to begin with. What is your response to that?
I think very simply, whether it's aggregators or taxi drivers or trade union associations, they cannot hide behind this excuse of cost when it comes to the safety of women. And I have to appreciate you that way back in 2017, you were one of the first channels and you personally were one of the first people to speak about this threat. And you also pointed out that statistically, more number of rapes occur in cabs that do have child locks, and it's a very serious concern. As of yesterday, the government has also hauled up and sent notices to aggregators on what they're doing. But on the government's part, very simply, this process started in 2018 legally when the Ministry of Women and Child said this should be disabled everywhere. Karnataka last year amended the act and has sent notices to everybody in December 2018. As of now is a special drive. There are 11 committees that the government has started up. RTOs are working on Sundays, and an argument of 400 rupees on each car to disable a child lock is obviously not something you can weigh out when it comes to the life of a woman and the safety and the security. What Mr. Tanveer is speaking about is fallacious. If there is a child, first of all, there's a problem with a very young unaccompanied child in a cab in itself. But the simple solution is you make them sit in the center of the car and have a seat belt on and basically not allow them to move towards the doors, right? And I don't believe it's a safety argument. And second of all, it does not matter very simply what the cost is, as long as it comes to the safety of a woman, especially in a country where the safety of women is deteriorating. And the government is taking all steps. We've been one of the foremost states in that term, and we've given them a deadline till 16th, and they haven't complied. And aggregators have the responsibility of cost, because aggregators are making money. They do have the purchasing power. Then they should, there are 60,000 cabs under aggregators in this state, and they should be the ones taking and bearing the responsibility, because they need to assure the safety of women on our streets, Faye.
Anand Gurumurthy of the BJP, we know that Nitin Gadkari's ministry has also moved a similar ruling. What is your opinion currently with regard to Tanveer Pasha and the rest of his association refusing to disable child locks in their cars?
I would request the Taxi Drivers Association from our end also that please take it to the conclusion and, you know, disable the locks for now. Because, see, international norm says that child locks should be there. So what Tanveer is telling is also right. And when I talked to some taxi drivers, because this program discussion came to me in the afternoon, I talked to some taxi drivers also. They had one major concern. When the passengers get down, especially in our country, what they do is on the right-hand side street, passenger seat, they don't see back. They just get down. Sometimes this also causes accidents. So some of the taxi drivers, they have a habit of putting child lock on the right-hand side passenger seat, so that they don't get down from the right side. So these kind of small concerns are also there. So even the passengers have to take care, because if the car gets damaged, if they get hurt, that also leads to problems. So there are certain problems. Other than that, what the government is asking, what the NCW is asking, is completely, for now, it looks very good decision. And I request the Taxi Drivers Association also just take it to conclusion. Please convince. You have done so much, you know, you take so much of trouble to ensure that people reach home safely. Please do it. Please do this also. Maybe in the long run, we'll have a better solution. For now, please do it for all of us.
Well, I understand what you're saying, Anand Gurumurthy, but a lot of these things can be solved with simple communication. When the taxi stops, you simply say, Madam, akade in the traffic bartha ide, ikade in the neevu get down maadi, or jopanvagi open the door. These are the things you can say to just make sure they don't open the door into traffic. But look at what we're talking about on the other side. We're talking about safety of human beings. I just want to bring in Vikram Singh. Mr. Singh has been listening very patiently. He a former senior police officer. Mr. Singh, do you I'll play this out. We sent a reporter out today to speak to mechanics to find out what it costs and how long it takes to remove the child lock. It costs about 400 to 600 rupees per door, and it's only in the back doors, and it takes 2 hours to do. Do you think it's an unreasonable ask?
This is hardly unreasonable. This is pittance, taking into account the long-term consequences and what you would be doing a tremendous service to the women folk, and also assuaging the feelings of the victims. I think you'd be doing a service to your association, to your community, and to your tribe. I think this is your bounden duty. You don't have any choice, Mr. Pasha. Now the rules have been amended, the motor vehicle rules have been amended. Now the choice is that you get it done as the earliest as is possible, because RTO are sitting on Sundays and it has to be ensured by 31st of January. And this is hardly anything. This is not even the earning of half a day. And giving up 60, and that is in respect of those that are old taxis. The new taxis can do away with this unnecessary appendage and can save the cost of the child locks. And therefore, at the end of the day, the aggregators save money, the taxi drivers save money. But for those who are saddled with an appendage, well, just too bad. You have to pay those 1600 rupees and get over it, rather than pay the challan and suffer yourself repeated visits to the RTOs to get your license back and be a repeat offender and
go
to the police
station.
You get off of the hook around the cheap lay.
Well, one second, before I go to Trisha, sir, just if you're looking at the visual that's running on our screen, and this is shot at the RTO in Bangalore. Now, we assumed, and when we spoke to the mechanic in Mumbai, he said that the entire, paneling from inside the car will have to be removed, and then the child lock will be disabled, and we put it back. But it does seem like the police at the RTO is just knobbing out the button. And that shouldn't take an hour or cost 400 rupees. All he's using is a screwdriver. Is this also effective? In which case, the argument that it's an expensive process doesn't even stand.
Yeah, no, certainly it's not an expensive process. It's a mechanical device. It doesn't require any sort of electronic intervention. Even in cars that have electronic door locks, it's still a mechanical device. So it's certainly not a very complicated procedure to do at all.
Right. I also want to bring in the voice of Trisha Shetty at this point. Trisha, I'm sure you are familiar with the number of crimes that have taken place against women, particularly targeting women late at night, alone in the backs of these cabs. And even though, and a lot of these cases have been obvious about the fact that even though we believe that the aggregator is tracking the car, we believe that, oh, there is an SOS button, or we can be able to call someone, regularly we hear cases about women being taken advantage of. Now, my concern is the drivers who spoke to our camera and said, these women are dressed badly, they're out, they're roaming about the city, at 12 o'clock in the night. They're drinking at parties. What else do they expect? What is your reaction to this?
You know, this is as absurd as people blaming chow mein for the rising incidence of rape in India. You see this very often when people want to not take responsibility and onus of women's safety as they rightfully should. They're quick to blame women, which is completely abhorrent and unacceptable. And let's dissect a few points, right? Even if you press the SOS button that these apps do have, what is the intervention period? By the time, you know, the police is intimated, the fastest anyone can come is police because they have jurisdiction everywhere. By the time they could actually intervene, an incident in all likelihood has already occurred. So in no way is pressing an SOS button going to stop you potentially from getting assaulted per se or deter a crime from really occurring. What it can do in all likelihood is track you down and make sure that they can intervene at a later period as soon as possible. So that SOS button anyways doesn't really prevent a woman from getting assaulted at that moment should she be in immediate danger. The second aspect of the cab driver saying they just don't want to because women are getting out late. I mean, this all goes back to women, to Faye as we know it, attacking a woman's mobility and her freedom. This is all highly restrictive. Anyways, women have it tough enough. Every time they step out on the streets, we have to account for, you know, who's going to touch us, who's going to stare at us. We're trying to, you know, put added layers of clothing as though it's going to make us safer. And then you attack our mobility. You attack our freedom of movement. And which in effect, you know, again, serves as a deterrent for, again, employers then saying, oh, it's so much difficult to, you know, hire women. We have to account for their safety when they're traveling and this and that. It all goes back to, again, time and again, establishments not doing what they need to be doing by law to account for women's safety and thereon putting the onus of women's safety back onto ourselves. And how many instances should we hear of? Terrifying instances where, you know, you're in cabs, you feel unsafe, someone's locked you. So to hear these cab guys say women who party late ask for it is absolutely abominable and should not even be entertained as a line of thought. I mean, imagine the amount of importance they are giving to saying that a cab may get dinked, door may get dinked if you open it. You know, sometimes people can be reckless if they open it and someone may hit it. So that material object being dinked is such a concern for them when, as you rightfully said, they can simply say, madam, be careful when you're opening the car door. That they want to give so much attention to, but they won't give attention to a very real cause and issue of women's safety that doesn't just start and stop in getting into a car and getting out of a car. It affects a lot of other actions and decisions that we take in day-to-day life. So even for the government, they must take further responsibility, not an attack against the current administration. All governments put into play because the larger picture of women's safety falls under the purview of the government. So the cab guy should not get away with issuing such ridiculous excuses that it's, you know, that is upon women. I think it's incumbent upon institutions, the cab aggregate companies, as well as the government to hold these people accountable.
All right. So this is what we're going to do. And since everybody's had their chance to make opening statements, I'm opening up the phone lines at this point for anyone who calls. And I know that there are a lot of people watching at home right now who might think that this is very drastic, that removal of child locks is not necessary. Pick up the phone and call us and we'll try and answer as many of those questions as possible because we have representatives of both the Congress and the BJP. We have a senior police officer. We have someone who really understands cars. And we have Trisha who fights for women's safety. So we'll try and answer as many of these questions as we can because the idea, and this is what I would like, is for each of us to form an opinion so that we can support the governments when the governments bring in these regulations to make taxis safer for women. Now, Prashant Pandey on the phone line from Bhopal. Prashant, go ahead.
Yeah, my view is that
yes,
child security is a basic concern across globe.
Yes.
So the child lock is for that. It's like banning acid doesn't ban doesn't stop acid attacks. Similarly, banning child lock will not have any impact on women's security.
Okay, I just want to first clarify one thing, Mr. Pandey. I appreciate your phone call, but banning acid will stop attacks on women. And the fact that acid is available in our shops for about 40 rupees and it can be used to, as a weapon to completely ruin a human being's life is atrocious. So I stand by banning acid as well. But to answer your question about the fact that it's a child safety feature and so we shouldn't remove it. Sergis Barreto of Autocar India, do you want to answer that question, please?
Yeah, sure. I think he does have a point. It is a child safety feature. It is called a child safety lock. It prevents a child from, you know, accidentally opening a door. and potentially, well, you know, ending up in further trouble. Having said that, yes, it can be misused, as with every technology. I think, you know, a knife cuts fruits and, well, it can cause much more damage than that too. There is another solution, Faye, which, you know, internationally, if you look at the London Black Cab, which is a specific taxi model, they have an electronic system. It's quite simple, really. While the car is in motion, the doors remain locked. And when the car is stationary with the driver's foot off the brake, the doors are all unlocked, you know, so there is no chance for the driver to stop the car and try and get into the back and attack the passengers, because as soon as he stops and he lifts his foot off the brake, the doors unlock. Yes. So, of course, it's a lot more, well, I would say expensive a system. It's an electronic system, but it would take take care of both concerns, you know, right. Both
and
for
Sir,
keeping children safe in the car
you.
While it's moving and helping somebody escape.
Yes. My question to you is this. You did see, and I agree with you, the child lock is a safety feature for children who are sitting in the back seat. Now, from our research on Mirror Now, we found that it was introduced largely for children in passenger private cars who are sitting in the back seat by themselves. And in India, it's almost extremely rare for a child to be seated in the back of a taxi alone. I mean, no taxi driver would accept that that fare at all, to have a child seated at the back seat by themselves. They'd always expect an adult to be with that child. So in that case, the odds of the child opening the door and falling out while an adult is sitting next to him or her, a toddler doing something like this in India, would be rare. But I agree. And one of the problems we encountered when we recommended other solutions to the government is that in India, we don't manufacture commercial vehicles separately. The car is just manufactured at the shop, and then it is the owner of the car that decides whether to drive it as a passenger vehicle or drive it as a taxi. So that was the main challenge, in the sense that, you know, using the London model would be difficult because we don't manufacture taxis in India. Sergis?
Exactly. I think that's, you know, I mean, that's the route. If we look at the longer and the bigger picture, we have to look at specific models, or if not models, at least specific variants of cars that are approved for taxi use. Right now, from what I know, at least, it's like a free for all. Anyone can be a taxi driver as long as he has a license and can buy just about any car. You know, so I think if we specify certain variants, at least, we could take care of a lot of concerns.
Absolutely. We have another call from Basavaraj from Mumbai. Basavaraj, go ahead.
Namaste, ma'am.
Namaste.
Actually, अभी जो फिलहाल में जो child lock का issue जो चालू है ना ma'am.
जी.
ये issues अभी जो Bangalore में start हुआ है. Bangalore में भी अपना जो senior sir है, तंगीर पाठक जी, नमस्ते.
हाँ. अच्छा, तो आप taxi driver हो?
Yes, ma'am. मैं
नमस्ते, नमस्ते.
टैक्सी ड्राइवर हो, अपना जो यूनियन लीडर थे वहाँ पे बैठा हुआ है तन्वीर जी, और उन्होंने अभी बेंगलोर में भी इश्यू फेस कर ही रहे हैं, मुंबई में भी वही करना पड़ रहा है. मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि चाइल्ड लॉक आप हमें सिर्फ टी परमिट टूरिस्ट व्हीकल को क्यों कर रहा है, और आप टैक्सी का ब्लैक एंड येलो प्लेट एंड ब्लू टैक्सी उन लोगों पर ये एक्शन क्यों नहीं लेता गवर्नमेंट.
In 1 minute, Basavaraj, if you can speak in Kannada, then tell me in Kannada. Nimgen bekagite. You're saying that the Kali Pili taxis you could or child lock remove maadbeka.
Illa madam, ivaga en gotha yavade taradalli bandibittu tourist permit ge bandibirtare. Ivaga naavu Ola Uber inda tumba kashta padta idivi. Antadralli ivaga government ge ondu rules namakoskarane tale mele bhara aagta ide.
Okay. One name, Shanan Keltiri. Aishwarya Mahadev is with us from the Congress Party. Aishwarya, is the rule only for Ola Uber drivers, or will you apply it to all yellow board commercial vehicles who carry passengers?
So, in Karnataka, if I may answer in Kannada or English for his clarity?
In English first, so everyone in the audience can understand.
I'll say and it then in English first. Yeah. Okay. No. So the law, the amendment was to the Karnataka, you know, the Aggregate Carriers Act. And then last year what the government did was they basically said anybody, any aggregator or any stage carriage or motor carriage being used as a taxi is something where we have to get this done. And 60,000 cabs are not only under aggregators, but in Karnataka it is also for, let's say, the bus. In the bus stand you have the taxis after, or even the railway station. So this is a rule that applies to all vehicles that are going to be used as carriage for hire privately by individuals. So Basavaraj avare ivaga namdo niti ಲಾ ಏನ್ ಬಂದಿದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಏನ್ ನಿರ್ಧಾರ ಮಾಡಿದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಯಾವುದೇ ಗಾಡಿ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿ ಅಂತ ಉಪಯೋಗಿಸಂಗಿದ್ರೆ, ಖಾಲಿ ಪೀಲಿ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಓಲಾ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಊಬರ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಹೆಣ್ಮಕ್ಳನ್ ಸೇಫ್ಟಿ ಇನ್ನೂ ಮುಖ್ಯ ಅಂತ ಎಲ್ಲಾರ್ಗು ಈ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಲಾಕ್ ಬಿಚ್ಚಬೇಕಂತ ನಿಯಮ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ 2018. ಇವಾಗ ಸರ್ ನೀವು ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ 400 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು, ಆದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ ಗಾಡಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕುತ್ಕೊಂಡಾಗ ಹೆಣ್ಮಕ್ಳಿಗೆ ಅವ್ರ ಸುರಕ್ಷೆ ಇರತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ ಗಾಡಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ನೂ ಅವರು ಫ್ರೀಯಾಗಿ ಕುತ್ಕೊಂತಾರೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಾಂದ್ರೆ ಹೆದರಿಕೆ ಆಗತ್ತೆ, ಅದೇ ಎಲ್ಲದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರೋ ಕಷ್ಟ.
Well, very well said, Aishwarya. Basically said that, you know, while it does cost a little bit of money, it's also, it will give your passengers who are women peace of mind, and it will take away a certain sense of fear, and that's really important. And let's remember, when you offer the women of a society mobility and independence, it gives them a sense of power. Sure. That's really important. Vikram Singh, a lot of the questions that we're being asked right now is, why are you focusing on the child lock? It won't stop all of the assaults. You're just creating a problem. Now, a lot of research shows us that the ability that drivers have to lock someone in the car against their will is the first step. It's the first step or the first intent of malice. Do you agree that this will not solve the problem?
Let me put it very, very clearly, the cost benefit advantage apart. The certainty is that your patient researches, the in-depth and incisive researches have shown that the child lock is culprit number one when it comes to assault on women in taxis. Therefore, to do away with the child locks is our first responsibility. Now, after your determined campaign, this thing has happened in Karnataka. I do hope it is nationwide, because it is not an option any longer. It's a compulsion that this has to be there. 1600 rupees or whatever be the amount is pittance. And now to say, after hearing what the taxi drivers have to say about drinking, about the dresses, about the late nights, I think that they require a bit of psychiatric intervention also. After the child locks, all those drivers who came out with these pearls of wisdom, I think it is like moving IEDs in taxis. When our women folk and our children are subjected to this kind of a mindset, I think they require, Mr. Tanveer Pasha would like to have a profiling of such drivers. Profiling of such police officers also would be necessary in case they have this kind of a depravity or a decadent mindset. Short dresses, consumption of alcohol, it is none of the business of the drivers. It requires a multi-pronged strategy. But the first strategy, and I must compliment you, Faye and Mira, now that you have succeeded in what appeared to be insurmountable a year and a half ago. This is the first victory that you've had, and I'm sure there'll be many, many more. But removing the child locks from all cars, irrespective, all public transport, as Aishwarya ji said, from all public transport is an imperative. It's no longer an option.
Mr. Singh, I appreciate and accept your congratulations, and I share it with the entire team at Mirror Now, including our social media team, that has done a great deal in making sure that this video reached as many people as possible. And we have a very young team, so we've worked very hard for
this. This is a success story.
Yes, thank you. I did notice that Tanveer Pasha had something to say. Tanveer Pasha, go ahead. You wanted to make a point, or you have a question to ask of the government? Go ahead.
Yes. All the time, why everybody will come to the driver statements? So there are many sectors are molesting the women. Let me complete my statement. So, all sectors, even in the police department also, many complainants. Recently I have seen the newspaper, somebody, the complainant went to the police station, the police officer have molested with the lady. See, this is not the only one problem, the solution. Already the central government has informed to implement the GPS, panic button, everything. And we are not like neglecting, I am not telling that we will not implement this child lock system. But I am asking, what is the safety for the children? If does anything mistake from the children, even we only face that. If anybody, if doors open automatically by the child, so anybody met with an accident, anybody dies, even the driver and owner only face that problem.
Okay.
Why don't the officials think that?
Okay, let me get answers. I don't have too much time. Let me get answers to your questions. Aishwarya first.
Get the bail within 3 months and 6 months.
Aishwarya, go. Go ahead.
Okay. That is one of the most irresponsible statements a person who heads a union can even make. It does not matter what the cost is or what the circumstance or the perchance of a minor unaccompanied little child sits. What matters is the safety of women. For an odd chance of one very young child coming in who you can ensure precautions for doesn't mean you endanger hundreds of women. And to say this molestation happens in every other department, so it does, why are you going after drivers, is absolutely pathetic. This is like saying somebody else rapes, so I'm also allowed to do the same. And I really hope, sir, you speak with far more responsibility. The very simple fact is this. Drivers may be the most sincere. Okay, 1,000 of them may be more sincere. But if one of them decides to go wayward and one of them attacks a woman, that still negates the safety issue or the trust we place on 1,000 of other drivers. And the least you can do is ensure that this child lock is not there. If you're willing to say panic button, you know how much a panic button costs, sir, to install in your cabs. We're giving you an easy solution. And if you want us to travel in your cabs, you should give us this. And I don't think you can negate it by saying there's molestation anywhere else. And that is pathetic to be saying as a responsible individual who runs a union of thousands and thousands of drivers. And I hope and I know my government is going to take very decisive action against people like you who will not comply with this order.
Anyone else who wants to respond? Vikram Singh, I saw your hand go up. Trisha Shetty as well. Vikram Singh first, please. Go ahead.
Just two quick points, Faye, in the sense that a lecherous taxi driver is as bad as a lecherous policeman, as bad as a lecherous neta, as bad as a lecherous advocate. So, Mr. Pasha, please understand the law is very unsparing. Lechery is just not acceptable and a big no. Therefore, please don't think for a moment that casting the stone on the other person will help you, any of us in any way. Law is very unsparing and women folk have to be safe and secure in the cabs, in the courtroom, in the police stations.
Trisha Shetty, go ahead.
You know, I want to take a minute first to really commend Aishwarya for taking such a strong stand and vehemently denouncing the remarks made by Tanveer. My audio is not picking up what Tanveer said, but based on what they're saying, it seems like he's, again, going back to blaming women and putting the onus of safety back onto them, or basically saying it's not even an issue, which is really unacceptable. If you want to be in a position of authority, Mr. Pasha, and speak for your union, then you must take responsibility. And you're not doing anyone a favor by taking their minimum responsibility. This is what's incumbent upon you. If you want to hold that position of authority, if you want women to book your services, firstly, it goes back again to the basic fundamental guarantee of security for women. So how you completely denounce this? Have you even chided or reprimanded any of these taxi drivers who've gone on record and blamed women who dress inappropriately and in effect said that if I blame taxi drivers, if women are dressing a certain way? Have you reprimanded any of them? Have you pulled them up? Have you asked them for answers? Let me make it clear to you that the IPC, which lists offences of criminal sexual harassment, rape, all of this under law, in no way is there a caveat that says, oh, you can only report if you're dressed a certain way. You cannot report harassment if you're dressed in short clothes. So the law recognizes that any woman being touched without her consent, being harassed, is a crime. For your taxi drivers to say otherwise, and for you to not, on record, condemn what they're saying, say that this is not okay, for you to not put it on priorities to sensitize the cab drivers and make it known to them that women's safety is not an afterthought.
Yes.
It's a very real issue, is very alarming, Mr. Pasha.
Yes, I have one last very quick question, and this is a Ola comment on this child lock problem. And Ola said, we're working closely with the State Transport Department on the issue of disabling child locks in vehicles. We stand committed to measures to further strengthen safety across the mobility ecosystem. Building safe experience for our users is top priority. So I just want to ask Tanveer Pasha, the president of the Ola Uber Drivers and Owners Association, have you received any aid or help of any kind from either Ola or Uber assisting the drivers in making these changes or paying for these changes or understanding these changes?
Sorry, I didn't get you, madam.
Have the companies of Ola and Uber assisted or helped the drivers in any way to make these changes of removing the child lock, either in payment or in action?
No. They have not supported anywhere. But I one thing I wanted to clear here, I am not supporting any of the criminals, okay? So let them punish with the higher punishment, not with the smaller one. I am telling that, I'm conveying with all the seniors who are sitting in the panel, please raise your voice to implement the new laws. let them hang immediately, not let them to get bail in 3 months or 6 months.
Wonderful.
I'm not supporting. Because of these issues, even we are, our necks are down many times. So,
I'm not supporting.
Okay. Please don't take it in a negative way.
If you wanted to implement, implement in the whiteboard also.
Whiteboard.
It will happen. I won't remove
personal personal cabs are not doing this.
Basically, be assaulted and then you can hang them.
This is happening in the personal cabs.
How is it happening in personal cabs? Anand Gurumurthy, you have a response. Go ahead.
Yeah, Mr. Tanvir Pasha, I request you one more time. See, this is very important subject and we cannot go on arguing on this. So please take it in the right sense and please help us out, because the taxi drivers are the people who, you know, take people who have to go to the hospital in the middle of the night. We respect that community a lot. So this is something which, you know, is requested from the government end, because this is not helping the women travelers. And I think, you know, whatever the taxi drivers have spoken, okay, people are getting angry on that. But we also know how many times our own sisters, mothers, they are taken safely to their destinations by taxi drivers.
Yes.
So we respect that part also.
Okay.
So kindly request your association drivers and everybody to take this law and make it to conclusion so that we are...
Okay, I just want to point this out very, very quickly. We will continue with this campaign, and this is not targeting any particular group. But in the last few years, we have moved from using different kinds of public transport to using aggregator cabs. And there's a certain pattern there. You book it on your phone, you get into the car, you're a little distracted. It tends to be late at night. It tends to be after a party. It tends to be after you've had a drink or two, when you can no longer drive your own car. And that's a good thing, that people are not driving under the influence, they're taking a cab. But we have to evolve just like the market is evolving. Just like now the Ola and the Uber drivers expect women to use their service, this is a step that needs to be taken in order to make that service more secure. Prevention is as important as what he calls punishment. And I want to applaud at this point the Congress and the BJP, who have both studied the matter and have come together in unison to understand and to agree that this is something that needs to be get done. So state governments and the central government have decided that this is important. And for that, I will always be very, very grateful. On Mirror Now, we'll continue to push. We'll continue to answer the questions. We'll continue to look at new challenges that evolve as we evolve as a country. Thanks for watching.